Hi everyone, we'll continue with the pointers. So in the previous lecture we have seen what is a pointer and how we declare a pointer and how we call a pointer or how we access a pointer. In this example, in this particular lecture, I will show you what are the different operators and how we use the pointer operators. Now you see in the first line here, that's like I'm writing the program like int s equal to 10, so that's a variable. Int star ps, okay, that means ps is a pointer variable, and the pointer variable, the value of the pointer variable is the address of s, that stores the address of s. That is complete. There is one more way of declaring it. What you can do is, before you write the ps, you can write here it as int star ps. So you don't need int also here, data type also here. You can simply write pointer ps equal to address of yes. So this is also another way of doing it. So since you are doing it here, the advantage is that you don't have to declare or give the data type before the pointer variable. So because you are giving the value of s already to the pointer variable, that indirectly indicating that the pointer ps is actually pointing integer s, because integer s is already declared before. So this is also one way of declaring the pointer. Now we have got two operators here to deal with, right? So one is an star pointer, star operator, and another one is an ampersand operator. So star and ampersand both are called as a unary operators in C. Unary means you have got only one operand. For example, you have binary operator, plus addition is a binary operator. Division sign, you have got that's actually an binary operator. So this is this star and it has got ampersand, it has got only single operand, that's why it's called as a unary operator. So what does these two special pointer operators indicate? First of all, this you have to keep it in your mind very clearly, that once I declare pointer variable as integer pointer ps, then the variable ps is always a pointer variable. Then you don't have to use star to indicate that it is a pointer later on. Now after declaring the pointer variable, whenever I use the star symbol, that indicates, okay, apart from the declaration, wherever I am using star, that indicates the value stored at, okay, that indicates that you have to read it like value stored at. Whenever you have got an ampersand sign after the declaration, then you have to say that it is ampersand indicates address of. Okay, so this to be very clearly have to understand, you have to keep it in mind that star indicates value stored at. So if I'm writing pointer the star ps, that means value stored at ps. Okay, ps is different, value stored at ps is different. Okay, so now we'll see an example, the same example which we have used in the previous lecture, that is int s equal to 10, say ps, let's say address of ps. Once you declare s, it has got some address, that address, and you are indicating the pointer also, say ps is equal to, so the pointer variable ps stores the address of s, and the address of s is equal to 1440. Okay, address of s equal to 1440, and PS is a pointer variable. Now let's say if I'm using the printf function, if I call printf s, that will give me s equal to 10. Obviously that is very clear. Then what should it give me as if I call ampersand s? So it should be called as address of s, isn't it? Address of s. It is address of s, no doubt. If I call s, it will return the value s equal to 10. If I call ampersand s in printf function, that will give me the address of s. What is that? Address of s is equal to 1440. I hope that is clear. The next thing, I have got two operators together, that is star ampersand s. What does that mean? That should mean value. I said whenever you have star, you have to call indicate, that indicates value stored at. So you have to say value stored, that is star. You have got ampersand, so value stored at the address of s. Okay, what is the value stored at the address of s? Value stored at the address of s. What is stored? Value stored at the address of s. Value means the value have given inside the address, right? So that is 10 itself. Value stored at the address of 10 is 10. Value stored at the address of 10, that is 10. Clear? No doubt. No doubt about it. That is equivalent to s. Value stored at the address of s means that is equivalent to, that is equivalent to, that is equivalent to 10. Now so you should not confuse this one, address of s, that is equal to 1440. So let me should not get confused by saying this value address of s is equal to that. Okay, value indicate that. Now PS, what is PS? PS is a pointer variable that stored the address of s, that is 1440. So PS, value of variable, that is, that can be read as value of variable, value of variable PS, that is equal to, that is equal to how much? Value of variable PS is address of S itself, so that is equal to 1440. I hope it is clear. Now we have got star PS. What is star PS? Star PS is value stored at PS. Okay, value stored at PS. What is PS? Is 1440. So what is value stored at PS? Value stored at PS is S. That is equal to, so value stored at, value stored at the address contained in PS. Okay, that is equivalent to, that is equivalent to S itself, that is equal to, that is equal to 10 again. Okay, that is equal to 10 again. Then next one is address of PS. What is address of PS? What is PS? PS is a pointer variable pointing towards S. So that also is another variable that must be stored in another address, right? The value of ps is stored in another address. So I will write here address of ps, right? That's basically address of ps. Address of ps, let's say that is equal to address of ps equal to address of ps equal to some other address 1442. Okay, 1442. 1442. Clear. So here address of PS, that is address of PS, that is equal to 1442. Now the next thing is address of the value stored at PS. I think it is little getting complicated, but it's very easy. Once you understand this sign, what does it mean and all this thing, it's easy. Address of value stored at PS. What is value stored at PS is equal to 10. What is address of 10? Address of 10 is 1440. That is equivalent to PS. That is equivalent to PS. It's equivalent to PS. So you can write here it as address of star PS, address of star PS. Okay, that is equivalent to PS. That is equivalent to PS, which is equal to, which is equal to 1440. See, it's not complicated. You just need to read and see this video multiple times to make it very clear. To make it very clear, because at first instance you might feel, okay, it's easy, but later on when you have, when you do the programs, when whether I have to use star or ampersand, what is PS or star PS indicate, all these things would be confusing when if this part is not very clear to you. So please make sure that this is very, very clear, and you write it in your own words separately, and you try to write in a notebook, and all this operator, usage of operator needs to be clearly written. Okay, I will again tell you a few things. See, I have declared a variable s that is equal to 10. Okay, a pointer variable, I have declared pointer variable. It can be declared in two ways. I have declared it in this way, that star ps equal to ampersand s. That means ps will store the address of s. So that means s equal to 10, ps, which is storing the address of 10, is equal to 1440. Since you are declaring a variable, pointer variable ps, that itself has got an address, that is to be written as 1442. It's to be written as 1442. So ultimately value of s, if I'm just calling s, value of s, that is equal to 10. The second thing is address of s. Address of s is 1440. Third one is value stored at address of s. Value stored at the address of s means address of s is 1440. Value stored at the address of s, that is 10. Correct. Okay, that is s itself, equivalent to s itself. Then ps, value of variable ps, that is what ps is, the address that indicates address of s, right? That is 1440. Star ps, star ps means what? Value stored at ps. So ps is 1440. What is the value stored at ps? That is 10. That is equivalent to s itself. Then ampersand ps, ampersand ps means address of ps. Address of ps is what? 1442. So address of ps is 1442. Then you have got very interesting one, ampersand star ps. What is star ps? Star ps is ps itself, right? Sorry, value contained in PS, that is S. So what is the address of S? Address of S, that is 1440. Okay, so this is very easy, but you have to be very careful. You have to wait multiple times to make it very clear, then only we can go for the programs using this one. I hope this video is clear to you, and stay tuned for the subsequent videos. Thank you.